हाय ऑल, गुड आफ्टरनून। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद टुडेज सेशन। कैन यू हियर मी प्रॉपरली? लेट मी नो इन द चैट। कैन यू हियर मी प्रॉपरली? ओके, सो आई विल शेयर माय स्क्रीन, माय प्रेजेंटेशन। So what did we study in the last session? Last session में हमने क्या पढ़ा था? What we studied in the last session? Just let me know in the chat. Okay, about Arduino. Okay, everybody is saying is we have studied about the Arduino. Specifically, we studied in the last session was about microcontroller and microprocessor, right? Okay. Okay, microcontroller. So let's have a look what we studied and we will move on with the next topic today. Okay, so I will share the screen. Okay, so can you see the screen? Can you see the screen? Okay, you can see it. All right, so last time we have seen, during the last couple of, we have seen about the Arduino board. Okay, and then we have, last time we have seen about the microcontroller and microprocessor, right? So I will just give you a quick recap about this. So microcontroller is this one, right? So microcontroller have ROM and RAM inside the chip, right? But a microprocessor doesn't have RAM or ROM. We cannot see any RAM block or ROM block here. Okay, there is no RAM or ROM. We had to add them externally. Okay, so I told you that if we have a microprocessor chip, then we have to connect a RAM. Okay, and if you want to connect a ROM, you can connect a ROM, right? Something like this. And we have seen the example of this also. What are the example of microcontroller? Microcontrollers are used in small applications like washing machine, microwave oven, your clothing iron, right? This kind of application. And a microprocessor, where are the microprocessors are used? In the big applications. Like your mobile phone, your computer, supercomputers, okay, and big systems. All right. So we have seen this one, and we have seen like why we are using Arduino, right? And a few applications. I have told you about the Arduino IDE. क्या मैंने आपको Arduino IDE के बारे में बताया था? Because I think some of the classes missed the description of Arduino IDE. So let me know in the chat. Did we talk about this Arduino IDE? No. Okay. So as you know that we are going to program our Arduino board, right? Basically, this thing we are going to program it. We are going to connect it using USB cable, and then program it. So to program it, we need to use one software. It is called as Arduino IDE. It looks like this. Okay. So I will tell you how to download it. So you can see it's a IDE means integrated development environment. Okay, so whenever we are going to write a code, it is called as IDE. Okay, then we will be using this software to create, edit, upload projects, idea to your board, right? Of course. So we are going to talk about this now. Okay, so to download it, open a browser. Okay, have a look. So go to Arduino. Then go to main page. Okay, this is the main page, official website of Arduino. So here go to software and go to downloads. Okay, now here you can download the software, download the IDE. So according to your system requirement, you can download it. So most of the students should have a Windows. So download this Windows zip file for non-admin install. So click here, then go to just download. Okay, don't click here. Okay, if you click here, they will ask you for money. So click here for just download. Okay. So after clicking here, it will start downloading. So I have already downloaded it. So I will just cancel the download. Okay. So this is how it looks like. Okay. So I have an Arduino IDE. So let me try to open it. Okay. So I think I have deleted. Let me see. Okay, so it's opening, it will take some time. This is a software, you have to download it. Okay, I have just told you how you can download it. All right, so using this software, we are going to write our program. All right, so go to Arduino website and download this software, install it, then open it. Okay. You don't have to do it now. Just remember the steps, okay? All right. I think I have accidentally deleted my installation file. Okay, let me check here. Wait a second, okay. Okay, I think I have deleted the Arduino. Anyways, so it exactly looks like this, all right. So anyways, we are not going to use it right now. Right now, we are not going to use it. But I'm just telling you to download it. Okay. So let's move on. So today we will see a simulation platform called as Tinkercad. Okay. Tinkercad. Okay. So this is the website you have to go to. So this is actually a simulation platform. All right, you have to hear it properly. ये actually एक simulation platform है जहाँ पर हम सारे Arduino के प्रोजेक्ट्स करेंगे, राइट? एज ऑफ यू डोंट हैव Arduino हार्डवेयर विथ यू, सो हाउ यू कैन वर्क विथ Arduino? सो यूजिंग दिस सिमुलेशन प्लेटफॉर्म यू कैन वर्क ऑन दिस. सो एज सून एज यू एंटर इन दिस वेबसाइट, साइन अप, ओके, जस्ट लॉग इन यूजिंग योर गूगल अकाउंट और वॉट एवर ईमेल यू वॉन्ट टू यूज, देन गो टू सर्किट्स, ओके. सो बेसिकली इट प्रोवाइड्स अस लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म टू स्टडी सर्किट्स, कोड एंड 3D डिजाइन. All right. So these are the circuits I have taught in the past, right? There are so many. So the same we are going to do. All right. So if I want to show you something, there is something like, if this works, let me see. Okay. So in this way, we can program anything and put it together and run our program, our project. Okay. So I'm just showing you. We are going to have a look on this platform and we will see how we can use it. Okay. So the requirement for this is you have to use a browser, okay, and you should have an internet connection. That's it, nothing else. Okay, aapke paas internet connection hona chahiye aur ek browser hona chahiye, just like I have a Chrome browser, okay. So you can see this is some project I had taught to the students in the past. Okay, so you can see there is one motor, there is one sensor, one speaker, or you can say piezo is connected here, buzzer, and here is the Arduino, right? So let me try to see if, so this is the code which I have wrote before somewhere else. So when we start the simulation, we can see the behavior of the circuit. Okay, yeah, you can see here. Actually, this circuit, this project is to detect the distance. Okay, now this is the sensor, and when I change this pointer, this blue tick is used as an obstacle. Okay, so whenever I change this, you can see the distance is updated, right? Distance is 54 centimeters, and it is also showing as obstacle detected because I have wrote a program. If distance is less than 70, right? If distance is less than 70, then I will get this message, obstacle detected, right? Or there is some, yeah, okay. And there is one more option I have given here, that if distance is less than 70, the motor will try to move. So you can see it's moving, right? So this is one of the projects we are going to do. Okay, so I will have to disconnect the chat, post only, okay. So many students are typing up nonsense things. Okay, so rather than looking at this, just go back. So if you want to go back, click here on the Thinkercad logo. Just go back. If you have a computer right now with you, then try to open it, okay? Try to do some things with me. Anyway, you're going to have a recorded video with you also, so you can check it. Okay, so when you come into the circuits, go to create new circuit, okay? So on the new circuit, it will make a new project. All right. So whenever we make a new project, it will given us some random name. Okay, so it's some random name. I can change it. Okay, I can give it my name, something like this. Right. Then you can see. Now let's have a look and what is the meaning of all the things available here. All right. So this area which I'm highlighting right now, it is called as workplace. Okay, this is the workplace. Okay, so whatever connection we are going to do is here. Okay, so this is workspace. All right. Then this is the selection area, component selection area. Right. So from here we can choose the components whatever we want to choose. Now there are some options. Okay, now when you go to basic components, so you will see just the basic components we have to. So they will show you the basic components. If you want to see the all components, just you have to connect. You have to select here all. Okay, then you can have a look all the components provided by this software. Okay. So we will see all these things one by one. So stick to the basic. Okay. Now. This option gives us a detailed version. Okay, if you want to see what is the meaning of all the components, right? If this is 1.5 volt battery, so it's saying standard AAA batteries, okay, giving 1.5 volt, something like this. So they are giving a small description about every component. So we don't want that. So it looks good this way. Then, if you want to use any of this component, like we have a 9 volt battery, if I want to put it here on the workspace, so what I will do, I will click and press on this 9 volt battery and then drag it. Okay, what I have done, I have clicked and pressed and then I have dragged it. And if I want to delete one of this, so select any one of this, whichever you want to delete, and press delete button on your keyboard. When I press delete, it is gone. Okay. Now this is if you want to remove if you want to rotate this battery, how you can do that? Select this and you can see one option here. Okay, so this is to rotate. So when you click it, it will rotate. So in whatever direction you want to keep it, you can keep it. Okay. So this is to undo. Undo, redo, everybody knows. Okay, so if you did something by mistake, you can click here to go to previous state. All right, so this is how you do. Okay, this is undo, this is redo, this is annotation. Actually, annotation means that you can give name to any of the circuit. Okay, any of the wire name, so wire one, something like this, you can give a name. This is actually done with the big circuits. So if you are not building a very big circuit, then that is not actually necessary. Okay, and this is to hide some of the annotations. Okay, so this is also like a option that we are going to rarely use it. Like we will rarely use it or we will not use it. Okay, so we are done with this. Okay, don't click here. If you click here, we will go back to the home page. But everything we are going to do, it will be saved automatically. Even if your computer get turned off, if your internet connection is gone, you don't have to worry. Everything will be saved automatically. Okay. SMD means surface mount device. Okay. So SMD are components. We will talk about that later. All right. So now you can see there are some LEDs, resistors, push button, potentiometer. So basically, during the course of this, what we are going to do, we are going to try using all of this and try to use them. And we will see about the uses and working of them also. So like this, we have a thing called as Arduino, right? So this is the main brain of our system, right? I have told you. So I will just try to keep here. Okay, it's here. You can see it looks exactly the same, right? Now you can see here one is a code block. I have told you that we have to program this Arduino in order to work with it. Okay. So in the code block, we can see we can write some coding. So there are actually two options we get. We get this block coding. Okay. So this is kind of coding which is used for like kids. And this is the text coding, which is the actual written format coding, right? So in the text, we write some program. All right, in the serial monitor, if you want to print something, we can see some data here. About the serial monitor, we will talk later. In one of the project, we are going to use serial monitor. Then everything about the serial monitor will be get cleared. Now this is some default program. All right, so don't worry about the program right now. Right now we are just looking at the code. Okay, so you can select the board. So right now this software platform is giving you only one option, that is Arduino Uno. You cannot program any other Arduino. Like there are Arduino Mega, Arduino Nano, Arduino Lilypad. So this kind of Arduino cannot be programmed using this, but only Arduino Uno can be programmed. Okay, now this is some debug options they are given. Okay, sometimes what happens, so this is also very rare option we are going to use, because we are not going to build a very big system. Debugging means, this is the option for debugging. Debugging means if your program is not working well, that means it has some problem, and to find out those problem, we use this option. Okay, so as of now, we are not going to build a very big system. If we have any kind of problem, we can just have a look and find it. Now, this option is to select some libraries. Okay, so we have some set of libraries we can use. So these libraries, we will talk about the libraries later also. Okay, whenever we are going to use a display or any keypad or any motor, we can see the stepper motor or servo motor. So these are the type of motors, and to control them, we have to use some libraries. Okay, we will talk about the library also later. That what is library? Library means it's a predefined code. Okay, so everything will be written inside this library. We have to use the function of this library, right? And this option is to download your program. So if you want to download this program and use it on your original hardware, then you can download it and it will get downloaded, right? So its extension is INO. If you have Arduino IDE, then you can open this file. As of now, I have mistakenly deleted my Arduino IDE, so it's not showing that. All right. Now, let's have a look. So this is a default code. Now you can see that there is a pin mode option and it is written as 13. Okay, just have a look on this number 13 13 13. Okay, meaning is that we are trying to do something with pin number 13. We are doing something with the pin number 13. Okay, so have a look. To hide this, you have to click back to the code and start simulation. See what happens. Can you see something? You can see the LED is turning on and off. Okay. So during the session, I have told you that the LED, there are actually four LED on the Arduino. 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So about the LED, LED is internally connected to which pin? Pin number 13, right? It is internally connected to pin number 13. So whatever we do on the pin number 13, it will reflect here on the LED. So you don't have to actually understand the code as of now, but just have a look that we are what doing. We are doing this 13 high means 13 is on, then delay means it's turned off, then 13 is low means it's off. Okay, so I'm just telling you, you don't have to take it very much seriously as of now. We will talk about this in brief. So we can see in this is actually telling us that pin number 13 is on, then it is turned off, then again, it is turned on for some time, then it is turned off for some time. Okay, this is the meaning of this line. You can see pin number, we are doing something with the pin number 13, it is reflected on the L. I have told you that this is the onboard LED. So now if you want to check with other LED, if I want to connect the other LED, so here is the other LED. Okay, now how to connect an LED? See, there are actually two points here, anode and cathode. All right, so anode and cathode. So which one to connect where? So I will tell you. All right, so anode means A. Okay, so the meaning of anode will be plus. Okay, and cathode, meaning of cathode will be minus. You have to remember this. Okay, so best way to remember is this: if you get A grade and someone gets C grade, that means who is better? A grade is better, that means A grade have more marks, that means positive marks, right? Which comes first? A. Which comes later? C. So A comes first, that means A is plus, C comes later, that means A is minus. So in this way you can remember it. Okay, is there a problem with the connection of the voice? Okay. All right. Yeah, we are actually done. Okay, so I'm just telling that A means anode means plus and cathode means minus. So plus will always be connected to pin number 13. Okay, so plus will be red, like we have talked about this, and minus means cathode will be ground. So this is the ground, so it will be black, right? So let's try to see. We will start the simulation. Now you can see this LED is turned on and this is also turned on, right? So these two are blinking simultaneously. Okay, I will stop the recording.